90 days worth of supplies. The Foreign Minister, Julie Bishop, says the government takes the IAE rules seriously.
It's important for security, it's important for global security.
Yesterday, the Industry Minister, Ian McFarlane, floated the idea of either walking away from that agreement or taxing motorists who return supplies.
They don't want us to actually be paying these billions and billions of dollars.
ABC News, Canberra.
Police say there were no witnesses to a car plunging into a Melbourne lake, killing three children. The homicide squad is questioning a woman after her one-year-old son and four-year-old twins died in the incident. Police won't say whether they're treating the crash as deliberate, but are appealing for members of the local Sudanese community to provide information about what was happening in the lives of the family. The family of a Philippines woman set for execution in Indonesia for drug trafficking has appealed to Indonesian President Joko Widodo to spare her life. Shirley Escamonte reports.
The family of Filipino merchant Alonso handed a letter to the Indonesian embassy in Manila. Indonesian by an international drug syndicate and used as a drug courier to Indonesia, where she was caught with more than 2 kilos of heroin. Manila plans to seek a second appeal for the Filipino after the Indonesian Supreme Court denied a previous review.